In this video, we will discuss how to import different data files in Origin. We will discuss how to import XL data file, text file, comma separated values, a single ASCII file, which is in the date extension, multiple ASCII files, and text file with machine specifications. So all these we will discuss in this video. I will be using Origin 2018. And this is the interface of the Origin 2018. Here are the exercise files in which I have the Excel file, the text file with comma separated values, and so on. So the very first thing is that I'm going to import an Excel file. So I will go to File, Import, and then the Excel here. Here the Excel file is being shown, and we will have to make it sure that the file is visible because it is having XLS extension and XLSX extension. So from here we will have to confirm which extension this is, and we will click Add File, then OK, and then a new dialog box will appear. So we will have not to change the default values for a single file and press OK. And here we are having the data file. So now it is ready to be plotted. We will open a new workbook, and here we will try another way how to get the data over here. So this is to open the file and then copy all the data. So we will press Ctrl and Shift, and then the arrows key right and down. We will select all the data at once, and then we will have to paste it here. And this is the second way that we can import our data. The third way is the easiest way, and which is just the drag and drop method. And we will go to the file, and from here we will have to drag the file and just paste it here. It is to be noted that in the earlier version this thing is not possible. So 2018 or at least Origin after 2015 is required for this one. So these were the three ways we can import our data file. Now a text file, which is in a notepad and with a txt extension. So here in the exercise file I am having a text file, so I will have to import this file now to Origin. Let me start Origin, and I will have to go through the same procedure, which is File and then Import and single ASCII file. So this ASCII file, I will select this text file and open, and it will open this file. Now automatically the spark lines are being plotted, so it gives you the trend of the plot. Another way to do this thing is to open this one, Control A and then Control C, so it will be copied, and here we press Control V and the data will be pasted here. The third way is that the simple way, just drag and drop, drag this one and drop into Origin, and it will show the spark lines, means the trend of the plot. So this way we can import a single ASCII file. Similarly, the third type is the comma separated values, the text file. Now in the comma separated values, we will have the same text file, but instead of the tape separation, we will have comma over there. Like this one, that one comma one. So comma means these are the comma separated values. And now in the latest version of Origin, we can directly import this one. In earlier version, we will have to just put some input in the dialog box. Here, again, import single ASCII file and then text file with CSV, and it will import the data. Another way to do this thing is the copy paste, which will not work here, because if we copy all the values and we paste here, then it will not be in a separate column. So this type means the second way is not applicable here. So we will have to avoid this. And then the third, the easiest way, the drag and drop. Now the latest version understand this thing, that the comma means tape. So as I drag this one, then it will show me the data file. Now the fourth, we will have to import ASCII file, which is in date extension, and we are having in the exercise file in 4 a single ASCII file, and here we can observe that there are so many columns, means it's a big data, and we would like to import this one. So let me open Origin. And here file import in single ASCII file, and here I will select the file, open, and now it has opened the imported the data file. Now if I look at the row 1, then it is having some specifications, means the labels, so I can remove these labels, mean right click and delete them. And we can even cut and paste somewhere else if required. So we have imported the data. Another way to do this thing is the second way, the copy paste method, that I open a new book. This book is just like Excel. I just copy all the data, Control A and Control C, and then I paste them here. And now you see that it has automatically separated them into different columns. And so the data has been imported. Now you see that some data points are being scrambled. So to resolve this thing, I will have to select at the corner and then double click on the line, and it will fix the width of the column. The third way, the drag and drop method. So it's the easiest one, and just drag the file and put an origin, and then it will import all the data. So the third way is the easiest way, and just delete this one, and we are having the imported data. Now the fifth one is a bit tricky in the sense that we would like to import multiple ASCII files, means they can be two or more than two files, ASCII files, and we would like to import them. In the exercise file, we are having these three files, 5A, 5B and 5C. So I will open Origin. And then I will go to file, import, and here I will select multiple ASCII files, and I will select one, and then I will have to hold control key pressed and select the three files, eight files, and they will come down, and then I will have to say okay. And now a dialog box appear, and the last option, multi-file import mode. Here I will have to decide whether to open a new book, new sheets, columns and rows. So it's better to select new books, and it will open three new books here with 5A, 5B and 5C ASCII files. So this is the way to have three new books, and we can read the new books separately. In some cases, we want that the new books are to be, instead of new books, we want different sheets in one book. So for doing that, we will have to open Origin, then File, Import. Multiple ASCII files, and then select the three files by holding Control key. Add files, OK. As the dialog box appears, now here we will have to select new sheets. So it will open all the three files in a single book with different sheets here. So here we can see that all the three files 5A, 5B and 5C are in one book and different sheets are there. Similarly, we can open in a single book in different columns the same thing whenever required. Multiple ASCII files, and then 5A, 5B, 5C are selected, edit, and then OK. And as the dialog box appears, here we will have to select new column. So all the data will be there in a new column. And I can see it will give it to the sheet, will give the last name of the file. So here, from here to here, we are having one type of file. This is 5A actually. This one is 5B. And this one is 5C. This situation means file importing this way is required sometime when we want to read them in a single plot. So we can import the data file like this as well. The last way is text file with machine specifications. Sometimes we get a data file in which there are machine specifications, and it can be seen here that some parameters are given there, and those parameters are necessary because after some time we forget what were the measurement conditions. So these specifications are very necessary. So the one way to do this thing is that I go to File, Import, single ASCII file, and then I go to the text file and I double click this one, and the data points will appear here along with the machine specifications. So one way is manual. I select So instead of deleting from the source file, I am deleting from my origin file. Another way to do this thing is that let me open a new book. And here, I import single ASCII file and then this one. And I can now select the data point in the machine specification, and I mask them. So when they are masked, it will turn the color red, and then they will have no contribution in the plot. We have done all these Excel data, text file and text file with machine specification. Thank you for watching the video.